Hello everyone, welcome back. Hope you're all doing well. In today's video, we are going to fix this PS5 DualSense controller, which has stick drift. So, as I say, this DualSense controller, it unfortunately is suffering from stick drift on the right hand side stick. So basically, stick drift is when the controller thinks you're actually moving one of the controller sticks or one of the controller thumbsticks, but you're not actually moving it. Now that can be caused by a dirty contact in the actual thumbstick itself, or it could actually be a fault with the thumbstick. Now there are obviously quite a few videos that show you how to take these apart and actually clean the actual sensor or the contact on the actual thumbstick, but in this video we actually show you how to actually replace one and do a proper fix on the DualSense controller. Right, so let's just plug it into a GamePad tester and I will show you what I mean. Right, so here we are over on a website called hardwaretester.com/gamepad, also known as GamePad Tester. A great little website for testing any DualSense or actually the Microsoft controllers as well. So it tests all types of controllers. So basically I'll leave a link to this website in the description below. Simply connect up your gamepad, your DualSense controller via USB. So I'll just plug our one in now. And then what you'll notice, as soon as I move the thumbsticks on this one, the right hand thumbstick is jumping all over the place, right? That's not actually me touching it, that's just it doing it by itself. So that is what is known as stick drift, right? So I'm not touching that, but you can see on the right hand side that it's jumping all over the place. Right, so we need to take the controller apart. First thing to come off is this black cover along here. That just pops off. So if you get your pry tool, and just start working it round and start popping off the cover like so. It literally just pops off. Start at the bottom, give it a bit of a wiggle, and off that comes. On the rear of the controller, where the buttons are, these top two buttons need to come off. So again, with your pry tool, if you just pull one of the thumbsticks down and then just pop off the button, just be quite gentle with this. Pop it both sides like so and off that will come. And then the same on the other side, pry tool underneath the button like so, and then just gently just pop it off like so and off it will come. Now there's four screws we need to take off. See the Phillips screwdriver, there's one just here. So take that first screw out and then same on the other side as well, where the button was. So just here's a little black screw. And off that one comes. And then at the bottom, where you took the black cover off, just down here, there's one screw, and then there's another screw over that side. So with your Phillips screwdriver again, take the screw out that side, and then take the screw out this side. Like so. And then next, this white cover needs to come off. Now there's a couple of clips, one here that needs to come off. So just next to the headphone jack. So if you just gently lift up the actual connectors here, the clips, like so, with your pry tool, and then start working around with your pry tool the sides here, like so. What I tend to do is then do one side, just hold it, and then just make sure these clips haven't clipped back into place again, and just pop them up like that. Like so, and then this top part will start to come away. Now what I find easiest is if you use your pry tool along the side a little bit more, like so, flip it over, because it's actually the back cover that actually comes off, and then just lift it up like that, just pop it off, right? Eventually you'll see it like click off like so, and then you lift it off backwards like that. Okay, and then we're kind of getting into it a little bit more now. There's a few, obviously, cables that we need to detach. First thing to remove, though, is the battery. So just lift off the battery and then just disconnect it from this connector here. Be careful. Don't put it up too hard, but the battery will just pop off like so. Then we've got a number of other screws that we need to remove. So the actual battery holder. So there's a screw there that comes off. We can then remove the sensor down the bottom by just pulling out this ribbon cable just here, because that's connected to the actual battery back connector, right? So just pull that off like so. Then we can start removing the other ribbon cables. So you can do these with a pair of tweezers. I find it easy to do it with your fingers, to be honest. You can just literally pull them off away from the connector, like so. One on each side as well. Just disconnect those. Because what we need to get to is this PCB here. Now, what we're going to do is actually quickly just desolder the motor connectors, the power for the motor, because I want to take this PCB all the way out, just so it's easy for us to get to the actual replacement of thumb screws. So I'm just going to come in with my soldering iron, just quickly heat up the pad where the cables are connected to. They come off really easily. Just quickly desolder them. Like so. Now they're disconnected and out of the way. What we can do is just lift up this PCB, give it a bit of a wiggle, and then off that pops. Right, so there we are. With the PCB out, we can remove the thumbstick covers, and there we are, bang on to where the actual thumbstick controller is. Now, what we need to do is we're going to remove this. This is the right hand one, which was our 41. What some people do is, and this will work, right, but it's best to kind of remove them. What some people do is just pop the sides of these off like so, and then remove, there's a tiny little copper circle inside there. Some people remove them, give them a clean, and then pop this back on again. Now, you can do that, but it does, you know, it's wear and tear. That's why, it's dirty, but it can be wear and tear that why they stop working. And it's difficult to get these back on properly if you just bend them out of the way. So what I do prefer to do is actually desolder them and just remove this in its entirety and replace it to do a proper job. So here we have our brand new replacement. So what we need to do, as I say, is remove this one. And the way we're going to do that is we are going to desolder all of these solder pads, pop this one off, and pop in the new one. Right, so let's just kind of zoom you in a little bit more. So hopefully you kind of get to see what I'm doing. I am going to come in with some leaded solder. And what we're going to do is each of these connectors, we are going to add a little bit of leaded solder to each, which will help us remove the solder that is on the pad at the minute. Right, so eventually when you get most of the solder out of the holes, you should be able to give the thumbstick a bit of a wiggle and off it pops like that. Right, so that process does take a while, right? So you kind of do have to be patient with it. Right, so that's our old one. We need to just check these pads just to make sure they're all good to accept the new thumbstick. What I will do is just give them a bit of a clean with some IPA first of all, before we go any further, is come in with our new replacement thumbstick. They're only going one way round, right? It's pretty obvious from the feet, right, and the holes in the PCB. Pop that in like so, and then all we need to do is come round and solder all of the legs. So we'll come in with a little bit of flux and then get soldering. Right, so that's the whole area cleaned up and all those solder points look good. Perfect. Okay, right, let's get it put back together again. Right, so looking good. So replacement is the reversal of removal. So what we simply can do is just run through that. I'll fast forward through this bit, right, because you saw me take it apart. It's literally just doing the complete opposite. There we go, all back together. Let's give it a bit of a test on gamepadtester.com. Right, here we are back at GamePad Tester. Let's connect up our controller. Do we have any stick drift? No, we don't. Look at that. Right, so that's me moving it around. Brilliant. And all the buttons work as well. Good stuff. There you go. Perfect. There you go. Hope that video was useful. So how to actually replace the thumbstick on a PS5 DualSense controller. As I say, there's quite a few videos showing you actually how to clean the actual connector by taking off the side part, right? The actual resistor. There's a copper circle inside here and it basically acts as a resistor and works out how far the actual stick's been moved. That method does work, right? But you know, after a while they do wear out, right? So this method I showed you today is actually replacing the whole thing. So anyhow, hope that video was useful. If it was, please consider giving us a thumbs up. It really does help us out. Thanks very much for your view. Please consider subscribing to the channel. We are adding more and more videos each week now and releasing our videos every Sunday. So click that notification icon, the little bell, and it will tell you once we upload a new video as well. As I say, thanks very much for watching. Take care of yourself. See you again soon.